side. Happy New Year. Hey, we made it 2021. We are here the 1st of January. Well, Happy New Year. I hope your first day of the year started out well. Hey, I want to say thank you very quickly to Susie for yesterday, for bringing us a message, having us reflect on 2020. Everything that's gone on in that crazy year, we can park that year, which is good. And I like that Susie also brought a word out of Isaiah 61. Susie, thumbs up, double thumbs up. Thank you so, so much for that. Hey, Beachside, Happy New Year. I'm sure you've already had that said to you today at some point. Interesting word though, happy. When I think about the word happy, it's this word that really conjures up or comes up out of an emotion, an emotive state. I feel happy when. In fact, a dictionary meaning of the word happy says it's this, it happens through an unexpected, an unexpected happening, a good luck chance, they call it. We feel happy when that happens. Interesting, right? I thought, surely the word of God has a different meaning to the word happy, and it does. In fact, it goes much, much deeper than just a feeling. The word happy, translated in the word of God, is this word blessed. That when we are blessed, we are beyond happy. We are just satisfied, and there's this contentment. Blessed. In fact, Matthew writes in the gospel, in his gospel of Matthew, in three chapters, he records Jesus' longest talk to the crowd. And in Matthew 5, verse 5, it says, "Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth," it says. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Another way to say that, happy are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. This word meek, I thought about this word. I don't walk around saying, hey, I'm a very meek person, and I bet you don't either. It's an interesting word, meek, isn't it? But it's a powerful word. Do you know what I once thought the word meek was? I thought the word meek meant weak. Meek meant weak. Do you know what, friends? That could not be any further from the truth. The only thing that those two words have in common is that they rhyme. The word meek is this, and listen to this, because I want this word to really fall on you today, to land in your heart and carry into 2021. This word meek means to have power under control. Now think of it like this. You've got a horse and you have a horse trainer. The horse and the person who actually is training this horse, who out of those two has the most power? Who has the most power, the horse or the trainer? It's the horse. The horse has so much more power than the trainer. But the way the trainer controls the horse is through this bit and bridle, they call it. You've seen it, the thing that's in the horse's mouth. When that's in the horse's mouth, the trainer can hold that horse and can move it and control it and move it around place to place, because the horse is under control. It has power, but it's under control. Friends, that's what the word meek is. Blessed are the meek, those who have power under control, for they will inherit the earth. This, friends, this word meek is really an attribute of a follower or a disciple of Jesus. And friends, as we march into 2021, my prayer is that we can recognize and see that we have been given power through the Holy Spirit to complete the things God has for you and for me to do. But we do it, friends, with a submissive heart to God, allowing Him to work in our lives in every second of every day. The Apostle Paul, let me share one scripture before we land today. The Apostle Paul writes in Colossians 1, verse 11. He says this. We'll start at verse 9. He says that we continually ask God to fill you with the knowledge of His will through the wisdom and understanding that the Spirit gives. That is a beautiful start, isn't it, guys? That we can ask God to fill us with knowledge and have understanding and wisdom because the Spirit is teaching us, is guiding us, is showing us. He goes on to say, so that you may live a life worthy of the Lord and please Him in every way. He says, bearing fruit in every good work, growing in the knowledge of God, being strengthened with all power according to his glorious might, so that you may have great endurance and patience. Beachside, my prayer is this for all of us in 2021. My prayer is that we carry a meek heart, that we see ourselves as people who have power, but we are under control, that the Spirit is guiding and leading us. And my prayer is that God fills us up, as this scripture says, with a knowledge and an understanding, so you may see fruit in your life and you may see fruit in your ministries throughout 2021. That we are growing in our knowledge of how amazing and how amazing the love is that God lavishes upon us every single day. Friends, my prayer is that we can grow in a deeper knowledge of the love that God has for you and that God has for me, given to us through Christ, through his Son. That's my prayer. And when we do that, when we walk in our days and in our weeks and as the months roll on, that we walk with a joyful spirit. In fact, Paul writes, he says that in verse 12 in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, he says this, that we can give thanks. We can joyfully give thanks, he says, to the Father who has qualified you. Friends, you have been qualified, he says, to share in the inheritance of his holy people in the kingdom of light. Beachside, friends, as we walk into this year, into 2021, I pray that we can carry a meek heart, a power under control spirit. And we can see that he has called you and he's called me to walk with this meek spirit, but with strength, with a strong and victorious mind and heart, knowing that God has gone before us through Christ. Beachside, God bless. Again, I hope your day has started out well, your week has started out well. And we really do look forward to hearing and seeing God move through all of us this year. Guys, have a blessed year and we'll see you soon.